As Guo Jianmei once stated, law in China is a sleeping beauty. If China's laws were implemented more efficiently, there could be great improvements regarding the state of women's rights and interests. This is a worldwide problem with a worldwide solution. These issues are common to all of us. At International Bridges of Justice, a global organization that works to prevent torture and protect people's due process rights, we support lawyers around the world who courageously show up in police stations, courtrooms, and bring their light into the darkest corners of prisons. They have the prophetic imagination to believe they can, and therefore they do create a new future. We may not see these lawyers, we may not hear their names, but they are with us today as we celebrate the leadership of Guo Jianmei in the global movement for justice. In the words of a defender joined together with us in solidarity, take courage, friends. The road is often long, the path is never clear, the stakes are very high, but deep down, there is another truth. You are not alone. On behalf of Guo Jianmei, it is my honor to be able to read her message to all of you tonight. Dear friends and fellow 2019 Right Livelihood Award laureates, this Right Livelihood Award recognizes and acknowledges the efforts of my team and me to uphold women's rights and the rule of China for the past 25 years. Currently, pro bono work in China is facing enormous challenges. This award serves as an encouragement and motivation. In any society, the state of women's liberation is the natural yardstick of universal liberation. Ever since the Fourth Congress on Women took place in Beijing in 1995, China has indeed achieved progress in the protection of women's rights. Yet, there is much that we still can do together to address issues arising from deeply rooted traditional cultural norms and discrimination within the justice system. Myself and my team are committed to the vision of living a life for public interest, advancing gender equality through law. Striving to protect the rights and interests of disadvantaged women through legal aid, the center supports women in solving their challenges from our unique and innovative perspective. Our work integrates three core aspects to reach this goal: women's rights, legal aid, and the development of non-governmental organizations. During its 24 years of operation, the center has created a unique civic model of pro bono legal aid. The center has carried out a series of pro bono activities, such as free legal aid counseling, legal aid and pro bono litigation, initiating the network of Chinese public interest lawyers, establishing the training and practice center for public interest lawyers, and driving the implementation and improvement of legal policies related to women's rights and interests. Meanwhile, behind all of these difficulties, behind all of these achievements, are immense challenges and difficulties. The perception that we are outside of the system hinders the dialogue and collaboration between the government, society, and ourselves. The overall lack of gender awareness, legal awareness, public service and social responsibility in the society of our work to all leads to many misunderstandings and even threats. Shortages of funds and talent pose serious challenges for our work personally and institutionally. As regulations are not in place, even the institution on which these lawyers depend are hampered by fundraising challenges. We believe that if we are to improve the situation, we should learn to seize opportunities amidst challenges and strive for the advancement and professionalization of public interest lawyers. Firstly, we should raise the overall level of gender awareness and the sense of public service and social responsibility in our society. Public interest lawyers and governments should be in dialogue and communication to further mutual understanding, trust, and collaboration, creating a harmonious institutional environment for disadvantaged groups. We should, by all means, continuously cultivate and recruit legal talents, converging forces, and collectively advancing development of pro bono legal services towards sustainability, high efficiency, public interest, and professionalism. My aspiration as a public interest lawyer is really very simple. It is to let the sunshine of law lighten up every corner of our life. I am honored by this award and the recognition of the years of dedication by our team and the network of public interest lawyers across China. Thank you.